Assalamualaikum and thanks for watching. Today, I'd like to explain a little bit about absent-mindedness in the context of us pursuing attention management. So, as we look at attention management, what I have showed you in the earlier videos, which requires us to observe and also be mindful of two important elements, which is control and focus. Control focusing on managing disturbances, distractions, and focus is the amount of energy you put in to pay attention to a particular task in hand. So our natural condition is under reactive. There's a fair amount of control over distraction and also a fair amount of control in terms of being focused. Now, what we aim to have is the ability to be mindful, which is higher control in terms of managing distraction and also higher amount of focus given to the task in hand. Now, when we are being mindful, there is a tendency that we become so engrossed in what we do and we go into the state of flow. State of flow is where we do not have to put too much effort to control distraction, but our focus remains the same. This is where sometimes we do a certain task, certain type of work, and we lose sense of time. This is okay, although a little bit extreme, but ideally, this is the flow that we are looking forward to have, which is the ability to focus on something and, you know, just give full attention to it. Now, as we finish the flow situation or the condition of having that flow, we would like to retreat to the daydreaming situation or the daydreaming condition, where we let our mind relax, recuperate by not focusing on anything in particular, but we try to still manage the distraction. This is very common, and this is something that we would like to have. A little bit of daydreaming here and there is not so bad, because understanding the fact that it allows us to relax, recuperate, and, you know, just refresh the mind. Now, where does absent-mindedness happens? Okay, absent-mindedness happens when we are in the condition of, possibly in the condition of flow, which is we are too engrossed in something that we tend to not be able to consider any other things that's happening. So we become absent-minded in that sense. Positive, but still something that we would not want to have, because, you know, being absent-minded meaning that you're just focusing on something and without realizing what's happening around you. Next possibility of absent-mindedness is in the state of daydreaming, where we do not focus on anything in particular, but as we go longer in the state of daydreaming, we lose the control and we start to not pay careful attention to time. So we end up wasting time daydreaming, and this is not a good condition to be in. Now, the third possible condition of absent-mindedness is when we don't have control and we don't have focus, and we don't actually go into the state of reactive, meaning that it is a place where, you know, you're just not present, and this is very difficult and very dangerous to be in. Okay, so ideally, what we want to have is being in the state of mindful, being mindful of our surrounding. A little bit of daydreaming here and there to relax the mind is okay. Focusing on the work, having a good flow is something that we hope to have. But even if we don't get it, it's not a big issue. Okay, so that is where we are at. Just be mindful of the areas that I mentioned in terms of being absent-mindedness, because we do not want to go through life and not being aware of what's happening, even though we're focused on doing something that you know, may be of a positive thing for us. Okay, so that's my sharing for today, a short sharing in terms of absent-mindedness. I hope this video provides you some thoughts to think about and possibly be beneficial to you. All right, thanks for tuning in. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Stay safe.